third is going to be the link. Follow on the other side if you would like to decide to once again go with the Culture Band. Very, very respectable band, very highly seen. And let's be honest, if Culture was a band now, one of these two teams is definitely going to steal it for themselves. Claude, once again, very same, almost very mirror-like from the previous game. And that just allowed Onyx Esports to get the Esmeralda. Now, the real question is this. Will Evil Legend pick, I don't know, Uranus is definitely going to be picked, but will they follow up with the Damas? Nope, sorry, Scratch, a little bit too slow. They're going to go with the Atlas because they just know how much of a threat Atlas is going to be. And that might be putting a little bit of a dent for Onyx Esports' plan since they're all a team-oriented team.
Exactly, and I actually expected them to actually take the Atlas away, just snatch it over, because it was way too powerful over the side of Grassy. If they're going to be going for the same bands, of course, they need something to change. And the question now is, who exactly will be holding on towards this pick itself? Would it actually be Zaze or so? But now, it seems like a switch of sides, because they are planning, okay, you can have my Atlas, I will bring in my Lo Yi and my Tamas instead. But what do you think about this 1-1 here? It's been a while. I definitely would like to see 1-1 coming in to the pack. But when we talk about 1-1, it's more about mid-late game play style coming from the side of Evil's Esports. So they're going to be looking to take this carry to hopefully carry them to victory.
I think the carry is actually a really good pick because you have that mobility from the Phantom stand that just allows you to set things up a little bit. You have the wave clear from the spinning lightweight, and your ultimate just allows you to proc your passive a little bit more faster than usual. But I'm more of a fan of what Onyx Esports Anti-Mage finally got his Damos. After seeing witnessing his or facing his Damos for 2 games, I'm pretty sure Anti-Mage is going to be having a time of his life in that side lane.
And now they're going for the Kufa brand ban. I definitely would suggest them to do so if I have a chance to actually talk to them, because that's the only thing that could easily stop the carry on her tracks. While for side of Onyx Esports, I think they really want to find an alternative to really dish out those damage from quite a long range. I'm not too sure about the Farsa. It's still pretty much out in the open, so Onyx Esports can consider something of that sort. But there's still the Valir, there's still stuff like that. And yes, they will go in for the Farsa ban.
I believe the Farsa is a little bit more of a priority ban compared to the Valir, because now they know they don't really have many strong engagement, hard engagement heroes compared to the Atlas, which they had just now.
Yeah, they had the Atlas, so it doesn't make sense to even
exactly.
pick the Valir.
So now they look on the side of Evil's Legends with so many front line. What will be great to harass from the back line? And the Farsa is definitely one of the most favorite picks. And of course, she's a really great lane harasser. First pick here, I'm thinking they're going to be trying to go for a little bit more of a support pick, but they might just go for the Lunox.
I'm liking what I'm seeing, because now they are opening even more threats. Like, if you really want to look into how these layers are being dished out, they need to care about Uranus if he scales. Next thing is, of course, late game player will be the carry, and Lunox is going to be popping off somewhere from mid game onwards. But you know, Carmilla is going to be very, very interesting, because they're going to match that aggression. They're going to match some of these sort of a DPS. So they are heavily committing in towards this, as they will lock in the Granger alongside it as well to complete the entirety of this lineup.
I really love the pick of the Carmilla, because let's be honest, she's a really great counter-initiation hero because of her ultimate that just allows her to just regen back the amount of damage or any CC that actually going to be hitting towards that team. And that just allows her to just return and reset the fight for the team, because she is really equipped with not just healing, but also with the right amount of CC to just set things up for Anti-Mage and get the CW to follow things.
Especially when you have an Atlas on their side. So it really doesn't matter whether the Fatal Links comes out. Rassi, or whoever that plays on towards that Carmilla will be able to actually sustain very, very well. So last changes to be made before we secure all of this. Seems to me that Zaze is actually holding on towards that marksman. So I really am interested to see how well does he play as a marksman instead.
We saw him like playing a lot of the supports by now, and things so a really great matchup, really good thing. And that's the beauty about Evil's Legend, especially with the newly additional Pendragon as well, that just allow a very new, fresh start and fresh lineup that just puts a lot of this team into question, where it's like, is he going to be going for the offlane? Is he going to go for the marksman? Who am I going to be facing? That's going to be a really hard decision for them to do it. And I think that's exactly what Evil's Legend was trying to go for during this MPLI.
Exactly, and now it's time for them to prove themselves once more. Onyx Esports, as well as EVOS Legends, desperately needs this win in the Land of Dawn, and we are about to see who will be the one that will be victorious by the end of it all to find themselves facing off against Burmese Skulls.
Four members of EVOS Legends going to be in the middle lane now. This is actually interesting to see. That means they're going to be leaving Antimage to be farming for himself. That's going to be a free farm lane. I'm pretty sure the Lunas is going to be, the rack is going to be rotating towards the bot lane very, very soon, because she just realized that Antimage is going to be in the bot lane, and that's going to be a real threat if she doesn't really hold him down as long as possible.
That big rotation though, Antimage now getting caught out, 1v2, might just be even more pressure coming up ahead. This might just be Foot Flicker coming in, he takes the rune, he will walk away, and now that's a sweet escape.
So that just, look at how much damage he just done to just two members, Rexy and Rek, and the best part about it, they were all lined up just for Antimage to just go full damage with that Molten Sight. Thankfully, he wasn't really too overconfident or too greedy about it for the push in. Decides to back up because he gets a free lane for himself.
Mm-hmm. And for now, it seems like
Pendragon.
For most of all these part, yeah, Pendragon is actually taking too much damage right here. Very, very concerning. He still needs to actually clear off some of all these minions. But Sasa is giving him such a tough time. Could this be a solo kill? No, not just yet.
Still? And the thing is, it's just really hard. Now, Sasa, like, we all know by now that Esmeralda really, like, punishes, not very heavily, but just punishes the Uranus. But there are cases where we see, depending on who is using that hero, they can fully utilize it and actually be the one that's winning instead of the usual by analysis. Still see that we're going to be pushing in, going to be popping the Death Sonata, doing quite the amount of damage. But I guess, was it a misclick or is this like just more like a presence, you know?
I felt so as well. And now seems to me that it may not be too much of a mistake, but now with a little bit of that rotation coming out from some of the supports, there's some threat over inside of Pendragon. But hey, closer to level 4. This is why Onyx really wants to push those buttons in. And even though from the bottom side, here comes EVOS.
Anyway, Rossi is still holding down the line towards his bush, just giving that presence to reassure to EVOS Legends, like, hey, you want to die my teammate, I'm right here, and I can deal with you anytime at any point of the day. Rek is going to be leaving the lane once again. Antimage is going to be getting another set of free waves for himself here. Now, is this a play where EVOS Legends is trying to force Antimage to back away from the lane and rotate towards the middle to just waste time, or is this something entirely new here?
Well, I do think that is a very different approach. Yesterday, they definitely want to actually look for certain catches. And speaking of that, look at how they are rotating coming from the side of Onyx Esports. This is it.
And still going to be pushing forward. So look at the amount of damage going to be following up by CW. So going to be forcing it back. And Antimage, I just love he decided to go for the flying. Try to see if he can catch towards that backline. Going to be a little bit careful. He has no ultimate. He's going to be going for this 1v3 situation. That, if he had his ultimate, maybe it might be a little bit different. But I guess he decided to hold down the line, buying out more time for them to try to take this first turtle for themselves.
And of course, Onyx Esports actually start off really strong with 1k in the back already. And for EVOS Esports, they should be able to actually find a little bit of neutralizer eventually as they slowly scale up. Nobody's really trying to wreck this well. Mm. So I really wonder whether or not if Onyx Esports, you know, they have any plans to dish out against them. But oh boy, Pendragon.
Definitely not having the time of his life at all against Sasa. But then again, Sasa will have to hold back because he doesn't really have enough mana. And I think it's totally fine because this also just allows Pendragon to fall back as well. Just get a couple of items, reset and get into the situation. But Drain got to be a little bit careful. But sadly, he actually committed the fail lane and Z's will not be able to connect it either.
Mm-hmm. And we are seeing a lot of all these members of Onyx just dishing out all these elements. Oh boy. Look at the damage though. Not going to be enough, but that's enough to just buy enough time for the side of CW. But lucky enough, there's no Death Sonata left available for CW.
Oh, Rossi. I believe he's ready to jump in any time, but he's going to be walking right into the face of Z. He's going to be popping the Annihilate. Not going to be committing the failure because he still has it on cooldown. But once it comes off, he's going to be coming and trying to dive into the mix here. Perfect match will be able to connect, but that's just the setup to allow Rossi to just deliver amount of harass here.
Hmm. And of course, just a couple of pokes won't really be too much of a harm. As Onyx waiting for the turtle to be spawned up, gotta get that river crab for Sasa. While Zay's just camping out for quite some time. Little Wanderer already being secured by the side of Wand, so a little bit of regeneration going on for them, so they can last for a little bit longer. Turtle's coming up in about 10 seconds from now. Ooh. Let's see what will happen from here.
Oh, I think that... I just love the fact that the decision maker coming from Z is not really committed towards that one kill on Carmilla. He's just like, you know what, my goal is that turtle. I want to go for it. I don't want you. Like, you are not on my list at all.
Now we see concentrated energy being bought there by the corners of Wreck for sure. But this turtle eventually get yoinked away from the side of Evil's Legends. Now, question now here is, can this three members by the corners of the river match up against Evil's Legends? Because now they are hunting over the side of Zay's. Fatal Wings has been popped up and Rassi getting caught up all by himself. This is going to be the turtle going over the side of Onyx Esports as they will lose to Carmilla.
And the thing is just like, well, one Carmilla for the side of turtle, I think they're totally fine with it as well. Sasa still trying to hold down the line as much as possible. But careful, Pendragon going to be committing the flicker, committing the consecration, trying to do as much damage as possible. Zeus going with the perfect man, will be able to connect though. But Sasa's still alive with a slimmer of HP and will only sacrifice two members for the price of Zeus. And Rek is still free farming on the top side. And really great decision making coming from the side of him as well.
Yeah, really perfect engagement coming from them. But you know, like we're looking towards how they really executed it. I would say that it's all, this is a little bit of that positioning that they could definitely fix. But one here, one free tower after that heavy commitment, as he definitely will be snowballing from this point. Obviously, he got that one kill. Same goes to Wrecked. So all these carries from the side of Evil Legends, this is a better drafting as compared to what we saw earlier where, you know, multiple layers of threat that causes maybe a little bit of confusion of focus for the side of Onyx Esports.
Yeah, and by far Carmilla, by the way, 100% win rate, mainly because she was only picked once. This is actually the second time Carmilla get picked out. So will it still going to be continuing that 100% win rate? We're going to be seeing whether Onyx Esports will be taking this win with the Carmilla pick on their side.
Very, very vital information. Well, it's really down to Rassi because if he loses this, it's going to be 50% then. Sasa now having one as well as Rek. Oh my goodness, the damage is real good, but he walks into his trap. And yeah, I think that definitely is pretty much expected.
And the thing is this, right? They literally committed Sasa for a tower. They're sacrificing one person for a tower, although, sure, one did get the kill for it, so it will benefit one. But I guess in terms of the objective, I think it's a little bit tilting more towards Onyx Esports. Rassi is going to be diving down. She has the Crimson Flower just to slow down Pendragon, but they don't really have enough damage to seal the deal. Zay is going to be jumping in with the perfect match. Goes for the Fatal Links, pulls him all the way back, but he has to fall back because he gets a little bit low because Death Sonata is doing so much damage. Although Pendragon, he has the Oracle item, so he's able to sustain a little bit more in that fight, but they have to back up because not only did they lose their team fight composition anymore, they don't really have enough damage to follow up, so they're gonna relax a bit.
Yeah, of course, taking a little bit of that small beard. Oh, quick flicker coming from the side of one, and he spots out the threat coming from the side lanes as he immediately puts out the spell. And wow, I didn't expect Tamas to be 84%, but then again, we see the popularity of Esmeralda. It is something that is effective against her, which is why we see a lot more Tamas to play. It's not to say it's a direct counter, but it's something that is of an even matchup. Rassi, though.
Rassi still getting a little bit down low. Instead, get caught up by the carry. One finds the one he was actually looking for, and that's going to be really great. But happening on the top side, Luna's going to be popping out that ultimate because he really wants to try to delay this as much as possible. So everything seems a little bit good going towards the side of Evil's Legend as they manage to try to even things out here.
And things are pretty much looking a little bit dicey for the side of Onyx Esports. Just hugging by the mid lane towers for now as we are seeing a little bit more of that Servia commotion over top side looking for Anti Mage. Too close.
Definitely too close for Comfort. So Rassi trying to push forward, gets connected with the Fatal Links, although he already popped the blood all day, and he's still alive with it. That's just what I'm saying. Such a scary skill to allow to sustain the lane. Sasa tried to find a mix on Rexy. Rexy was able to flick out and will still be alive. But on the other hand, Juan is punishing anyone who's actually overextending. Drian tries to set things up for Sasa. CW getting ready. He knows he wants to jump it back and forth, but with the risk, but trying to risk the lives of his two members, it's too costly for him to commit here.
Yeah, and meanwhile, well, they did actually get a couple of all those sort of picks. There's still going to be Pendragon. Yep, pain in the butt Uranus is just going to be crushing things off from the bottom side.
Oh, man. Now, this is the part where Anti-Man just slowly punches Pendragon as well. Like, hey, man, you want to be a nuisance. I will be the one man you cannot absolutely forget. That's what Nana's going to be coming in. Just try to slow things out. Despite them, even though they did lose the defense for this first turret, this literally allows Evil's Legend to open up things a little bit and allow them to get a little bit more control.
Yeah, it seems like things are looking very much... pretty much at a good tempo for the side of Evil's Legends. Now that there is a Lord, but it seems to be that, you know, none of them are daring to make a move just yet. But as for Onyx Esports, they time the buffs quite well. They're going to be able to actually secure it the moment that it spawns. But top side, there's going to be a little bit of that fight, 1v1. But, you know, Rekt so far doing quite a good job alongside with Juan. But Zayce, of course, all he has to do is get in those perfect setups.
Yep. Lord slowly being pulled out once a bit. They just want to try to see if they can bait anything out. But even though if they did bait it out, they really need to be careful because right now Uranus and Carry is not really on the side here as well. Rag is caught off guard, instantly gets pulled and dragged down instantly. My god, the death Sonana coming out from CW instantly removes him from play with such ease.
Well, with that sort of pickoff, it's going to be an even number as well, as Onyx Esports is going to be pretty much in a precarious situation. And well, speaking of that, they will be able to actually get that kill over the side of Rexy. And oh boy, still that 1v1 going over there. Oh, mid lane action coming out from the side of Evil's Esports.
Man, we've been seeing a couple of clashes, a couple of brawls happening all over the side of the maps here. Pendragon finds one, Sasa dives into it a little bit because he wants to do a little bit more damage. Lord has already been taken out down to 50% HP. Now here comes the fight. Here comes the counter initiation as well. Lord really tries to set things up for the middle of the situation. Anti-Mage deal quite the amount of damage. But coming on the side here, Pendragon was able to seal the deal on our dear friend CEW. That's the it of their mark. So that's the it of their hyper carry. They're going to be forcing it back. Rossi gets a little bit down low. One going to town, but a little overextended. Sasa was able to jump onto the mix here. But one is still alive. Still trying to do it much better, but he will fall in the end. And with a couple of trades, 1-3.
Yeah, and of course, a great trade at the very least for the side of Evil's Legends. So far, things are looking really, really great for them as they manage to take off not just CW, they got Anti-Mage as well as Rassi as well. Necklace of Durance has been purchased by the side of Drian. So far, Drian is just playing a very supportive Loyi for now. Evil's now breaks open the mid lane and looking to actually snatch this buff away.
The Pendragon just want to try, and the thing is, this is exactly what they sort of go for. They want to try to get as much control, as much dominance as much as possible, and Rossi just not allowing Pendragon to do what he does best with the Uranus. Going to be trying to force him back, even commit the Consecration. That's actually pretty big, but Consecration is kind of like a low cooldown skill, so he's definitely going to be having very time soon.
And of course, Pendragon so far looking more stabilized than all the other games that they did play early on over on the side lanes. Malefic Roar quite early for the side of CW. A very interesting purchase coming in because he knows that he needs to actually dish out not only damage, he needs the sustainability as well.
Still, everyone playing a little bit time. And the best part about it is that it's really interesting to see Onyx Esports playing this kind of playstyle, mainly because they've always been this team fight oriented kind of team fight playstyle. So, really, it's really interesting to see how Onyx Esports is actually trying to play a little bit more safer than usual since the existence of Atlas on the hands of Evil's Legends.
That's something that I will definitely look into. Oh, Fatal Links coming in from the side of Rassi as well. That's going to be able to actually pull one kill in the form of Rossi. And over in the back is Animage going off of position. But look at Pendragon though. Ooh. He's actually rushing right in as they cut through all these units. Drian, the first death for himself as Sasa gets pushed all the way back. Evil's Legend says, I don't need the Lord. I will open up and tear things down and will be able to actually secure that inhibitor turret. But can Evil's Legends secure the win right there?
Oh my god, looks like they're going to be trying to commit towards this crystal as well. Literally two members are going to be coming out in exactly 20 minutes. They have that one siege tank, but they also realize they do not want to try to be too overconfident, too greedy about it. They're going to be trying to get a little bit more inhibitors before they push right back into the mix again. Pendragon, probably the Consecration, going right back under the tower, doing a kind of significant damage. Zeus gets his Fatal Lane, pulls him all the way back, but sadly, CW already come back to life, pops the Death Sonata, always able to get the couple of trade kills for himself, but will it be enough? More damage going to be popping. So Lo Yi coming for Drian does the damage, but remember, one is still alive. He's the threat. He's doing the damage. He's popping his ultimate. Now he's gonna. Now here comes a counter initiation. Drian has no choice but to back up, but so does Evil's Legend. No more minion waves. They cannot commit towards this minion. This mid lane.
At least they actually find a way to actually halt Evil's Legends, and I like how they were actually getting so much discipline out of that situation. But oh, Pendragon's looking for something right here.
They are still going to be looking for as they try to take this out. They will be able to take out this second inhibitor for themselves, but Sasa managed to charge up quite the amount of shield, commits the Falling Stormwind, will try to slow down Pendragon. Pendragon will have to commit Consecration and a Flicker to get out of that situation. And thankfully, he is still alive because I would not know how the result is going to be should he fall while they're taking the Lord right now.
Yeah, and of course, Pendragon actually did a magnificent work where we thought that he would go down, but oh my goodness, it's Onik here coming from the back. It's a backstab here with Zayce going with the Fatal Links, but no connection whatsoever coming from the rest. One still alive. How is he still alive? As we are looking at Wreck just shredding them to pieces, and there's only going to be Sasa and Image as well as CW left alive. So they say, no Lord, no problem.
Dude, this is the scary thing about Carmilla. Once she pops up ultimate, whether you're committing all your CC on her, she's going to be regenning so much. And that's pretty much why she's so tanky and able to sustain for so long in that fight. But sadly, there was no teammates on the side of Onyx to really follow up with the damage. So now this is probably going to be a free Lord for them as they just slowly clear it out before they push down towards that middle.
Exactly. And now with the Lord really going to be giving them that additional boost here, it looks to me that Evil's Legends are well on their way to meet Burmese goals if Onik Esports could not stop this point of push.
And you know, that was even the best part about it, that CW actually already prepared for the anticipation with if they win a team fight, they're able to be breaking down towers because he bought an item just now like a few minutes back where it really helps him to deal and melt down those towers as fast as possible. But that dream can only come to play if he wins this team fight, survives long enough with the rest of his team.
And we really want to look into it. Some of the goals that has been stashed up. Look at how rich both Lunox as well as the Uranus is right now.
Oh, man. Man, they be rolling in digits so hard here. By the way, this is possibly the final fight. Lord's going to be pushing down middle. They want to see how well they're going to be committing towards it and divide their forces here. Sasa goes into the mix here. And they try to commit as much as possible. One gets caught a little bit, falls back as well with the Phantastat as he tries to hold down the line. Breaks the third inhibitor. Now the counter initiation as they fight as this. Trying to fight the man they're looking for. Calls out with the Fatal Links with two men, but Sally on the other hand, Fun had to fall back. He does a significant amount of damage. So did Pendragon. Men will fall. They're all getting squishy, but they're going for the crystal, for the throne. Evil's Legends will be moving on, and Onyx Esports sadly will be packing back home.
And this is such an unfortunate bout.